Well, thank you, Shelley. I'm Mary Gordon, and a very good evening to all the friends of Walrus out there. I'm delighted to be part of this event, social impact event, and I'm going to tell you about how Roots of Empathy is changing the world child by child. Our empathy-based program started more than two decades ago, and it started in one province of Canada, and it has grown to every province of Canada in English and French, particularly available to our First Nations, Inuit, and Métis peoples. We're sometimes called a disruptive innovation, and when I first heard that, I was a bit affronted. But now I'm charmed, because to be able to be breaking cycles in an education system is something that I'm quite happy to sign up for. So how does this program work? You can see up here a picture of a tiny baby in a classroom. What we do is quite unconventional. We find a newborn baby in the neighborhood of a school. We train, of course the baby comes with the mother or father or both, and we train an instructor, and that family and the instructor visit with a classroom of children over the course of the school year. And the Roots of Empathy instructor coaches the children to observe the baby's intentions, to take the perspective of this wee little baby who can't walk or talk. And perspective taking is the cognitive aspect of empathy. And that's why we teach the children perspective taking skills. And it's also the very first stage of any conflict resolution. But the affective part of empathy is emotion. And we basically live in an emotionally illiterate society, and you shouldn't just go to school to learn to read, you should go to school to learn to relate. And we teach children unabashedly emotional literacy. They are guided to observe the baby's emotional cues, and of course the little baby's body is completely unfiltered, a theater of emotion. So as this unfolds on the green blanket, the follow-up lessons allow the instructor to flip that experiential learning to the children's own experience. When was a time when you felt frustrated like the baby? When was a time when you were so confused you couldn't find which way was up or down? And what happens is that the children do develop empathy. They develop it brilliantly. But usually people think, oh, well, why don't we just teach it at home or teach it at school? But empathy is not something that can be taught in conventional instructional ways. It's something that is caught rather than taught. And ideally, children do catch it at home. We are innately predisposed to be empathic, was my belief, and it turns out to be right that neuroscience is caught up with my guess, and by golly. And then the other part of it is we have this first year of life where the relationship between the parent and the baby is crucial. And if that goes awry for any reason, the parent isn't able to respond to the baby as she or he might, sometimes empathy fails to develop. And you can catch it up at another time in life, but not through cue cards. It has to be through true relationships. So the baby helps the children find the humanity in itself. And finding the humanity in the baby allows the children to find the humanity in themselves. And that is the premise of how we move ahead with Roots of Empathy. We say to the children, you know, when the baby grows up and comes to school, how would you feel if people say, well, you can't play? And they're horrified. Well, we say, aren't we all just big babies? So the idea that we are all the one is central to this. We talk about differences, but we talk about our shared humanity, which is our feelings. And our feelings are what make us human. They're the connective tissue of humankind. So why empathy is so important? Well, I think it's probably the ultimate human trait. It's deeply connected to our morality, and the absence of empathy is at the root of all violence. It's at the root particularly of child abuse and neglect and domestic violence, and it's certainly at the root of hate crimes and genocides. And if little children can develop empathy in their classroom while they're having a good time around a green blanket. Why would we not do this? So the program scaled outside of Canada. We're now in 10 countries in multiple languages. We decided to do a great deal of research on this program since 2000. We've got research from three continents, and the good news is that when empathy goes up, aggression and violence go down. And the good thing also is that children become more pro-social. They include one another, they help, they share, they care. They behave in a way that makes them enjoy one another. And it's used very often in places, particularly in Europe, as the inclusion program rather than the anti-bullying program. Empathy is a break against cruelty. It's not a guarantee. But I think, you know, in school, children learn many things. I'm a great supporter of teachers. I think they're my heroes. But you cannot expect a teacher to take on the whole issue of emotional literacy. And I like to think that schools aren't just think tanks. They're also field tanks. And when a child's experience in school is positive, the child is freed up to learn. And we find that the children in Roots of Empathy contribute in a very big way where they normally might not, because we come from a principle of intrinsic motivation. You only say something when you have something to say, not to impress anybody. So I'd like to finish up my remarks by saying that I believe childhood is a springtime of humanity. And if you can seed empathy in childhood, you can build a more caring, peaceful, and civil society. And that's a future worth planning for. And my final note will be a note from a song from the 70s that some of you might know, "Strangers Passing in the Street, by chance two separate glances meet, and I am you, and what I see is me." Thank you.